Yes, I do. Old song we sang many times, keep me sanctified when the storm clouds get. I mean, he wants to stay sanctified. Amen. When the storms is raging, keep me, Lord. Keep me sanctified. Can you say amen? Keep my heart right. Let me walk right, talk right, spit right. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Keep me sanctified when the storms are gathered, when the battle is rough and the way seems hard, when it cries so hard, I've been such a pain.
Them that are alive and remain
shall be caught up together with him in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. But those that have been washed in the blood, those that's not born again, those that left God, chose the world over God, will be running and crying for the rocks and mountains to fall on them, to hide them from the face of a living God. And you know, there's no time to take God. It's time to take God seriously. It's time to know for sure that it's well with your soul. Time is running out. Jesus is coming. I asked you a question tonight. Is it well with your soul? Do you know that if Jesus were to call you tonight, you'd be ready to go? Jesus would call your name. Your number would be called. You would say, "Here am I, Lord. I'm ready." It's like the woman in the Bible, whose son, God gave her son to the prophet. One day he had a heat stroke and died. The woman took him up and laid him on the man of God's bed that she had built in the house. She had told her husband and said, "Look, the man of God comes by here often. Let's build him a room. So when he comes by, he can just go up and have a bed and a table and a lamp. And he can rest when he passed through our way." And because of the good deeds to the man of God, he asked his servant one day, said, "Go ask her what she needs." He said, "She need me to speak to the king on her behalf? Or is there anything that she needs?" And she told him, "No, I have everything." But the servant said, "I've noticed they don't have no children around here." And the man of God come and stood in the door and said, "About the time of life, you're going to have a son." And she did. She had that son. One day he was in the fields and the heat got to him and he died. But she didn't give up. Heaven knows it's no time to give up. I know we're living in some tough times, but it's time to get up and not give up. Can you say amen? It's time to get back to the house of God and praise the Lord and not throw in the towel and quit the fight. Amen. The Bible said, you know what the Bible said? "He that endures to the end, the same shall be saved." He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. What about those that don't endure to the end? Now you got a lot of doctrine going around now, once saved, always saved. But what did he mean when he said he didn't endure to the end? He meant you got to endure. You can't throw the towel in. Heaven knows you got two fighters in the ring and they're fighting. And one of them drops down on one knee and says, "I've got enough." He's not enduring. There's no way he can win the fight. The fight is given to the opponent. It's no time to let the devil win. It's time to fight the good fight, Paul said, of faith. It's time to rise up and go on with God. Amen. I said it's time to rise up and go on with God. He said, "He that puts his hand to the plow and look it back is not fit for the kingdom." Amen. It's no time to look back. It's time to go on with the Lord. Amen. Many people are looking back. Many people are going back. Many people are throwing the towel in. Said, "I can't fight no more." But the Bible said, "He that endureth to the end is the one that's going to be saved. How many tonight wants to endure to the end? Lift your hand and say, Lord, I've got my mind made up. I'm going to endure. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to look back. I'm not going to put my hand to the plow and look back. I'm going all the way. And see what the end's going to be. Amen. I want to run my race. Don't you? I want to finish my course. All around America. Tonight, people are going astray. They're going back. But that's why I said, he that endureth to the end. I've got my mind made up tonight to endure to the end. And hear Jesus say, well done. You know, if you're in a fight, that don't mean everything's going smooth. Paul fought. You know what he said? I fought a good fight. I kept the faith. So Paul is telling us here, look, I had to fight. And you know what the next thing was? He laid his head on a chop block. He said, I fought a good fight. I kept the faith and I finished my course. Now there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness. In other words, he said, I made it to the end. I kept the faith. I didn't quit the fight. I didn't throw the towel in. I didn't throw my hands up. I didn't tap out. Praise God. It ain't no time to tap out and say, you got it, devil. Praise God. Reach back and get another win. Thank God and go back in the ring. Go back and fight. Hallelujah. Put up a good fight against the devil. So Paul the apostle said, I have fought a good fight. I've kept the faith. He didn't lose his faith. And I finished. I went all the way to the finish line. How many know if you're running a race and you quit along the way and you don't cross the finish line, there's no way you can win. You got to endure. You got to endure. How many have been running and you feel like your side starts hurting? You feel like you're just going to collapse. But you think, look, I ain't going to win. I'm not going to win this race if I quit. So you reach back and get another breath. Get another win, and you keep running. The devil will pull you back. He'll discourage you. God would allow him to try you and to test you. And knows that Job lost everything he had. Lost his camels, his donkeys. He lost his sheep and a whirlwind come and kill all of his children at once. But you know what he said? I know my Redeemer liveth. He was tested and tried. He said, I'm waiting on my change. My change is coming. Hallelujah. The Bible said, with all that Job went through, he sinned not with his lips. He didn't blame God. He kept the faith. He kept on going. He kept going even when he lost all of his children. As the enemy began to pour, the devil began to pour down on Job, Job began to send praises up to God. As the devil poured in some more on Job, Job would send more praises. More recognition that God is on the throne. I'm waiting on my change. I know you live. Yet in my flesh, I'm going to see God. God's going to visit me. Somewhere God's going to come to my rescue. Through all that what he went through, Job didn't sin. He held fast to his faith. I mean, it was his time to hold on. Hold on to Jesus. Like that song we sing sometimes. I keep holding on to Jesus. I keep holding on to his nail-scarred hand. The way may may seem so weary. Now I may get so weary, but I keep holding to that precious nail-scarred hand. Amen. And knows it's time to get a grip on that nail-scarred hand and hold on to Jesus. Don't let go. He'll show you mercy. Just because somebody else turned around, don't you turn around. Just because somebody else quit going to church, don't you quit. You go out, knock on doors. You go out and say, it's time to come back to church. It's time for you to pray. It's time for you to come back to God. We read in the Bible a story. In the 15th chapter of the book of Luke. How that this man had two sons. One of them told him, said, I want what belongs to me. The Bible said, for too long, he took his journey and left home. That's what's going on with a lot of folks are leaving God. They're leaving home. Many preachers are compromising. They're watering down the word of God. They're sugarcoating it. They're no longer telling the people the truth. Bible said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Let me tell you that in God's word, we have everything we need. In this book called the Bible, we have all of our needs met. You read it and believe it. God will work for you. You'll get out on your knees and call upon the name of the Lord. The Bible said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. See, the devil tries to make it difficult. The devil tries to make you think it's hard to get saved. See, I thought the same thing. I thought I had to do better before I could go to church and get saved. I thought I had to straighten up before I could go to church and get saved. So I would try to straighten up. I would try to do better. But it seemed like I didn't have the strength in myself to do better or to do right. So one day I decided I was going to church just like I was. I got there that day. I don't remember what the preacher preached. I was under search conviction. But I remember the song they sang when they gave the altar call. Just as I am, without one plea. But that time blood was shed for me. Oh, Lamb of God, I come, I come. And I said, he must be talking about me. And I found out, you don't need to do better to get saved. You just need to come as you are, just as I am. Just as I am without one plea. I want you to know the blood of Jesus can wash the worst of sinners' sins away by the precious blood. There ain't no good sinners and bad sinners. You're just a sinner or you're a saint. Praise God. But God can forgive you. The blood of Jesus can wash your sins away. There's no sin that the precious blood of Jesus can't wash away. And if you fail God, if you sin, once you come to Him, ask Him to forgive you, then He takes your sins and washes them. Just like the Bible said, He takes away. St. John 1 and 29, He said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world. The blood of Jesus takes away your sins. When He forgives you, He washes away your sins. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus right now. Right now. He will save you. He will save you. He'll save you right now. Do you believe that tonight? Jesus is still in the saving business. He's still in the healing business. Here in the book of Luke, chapter 15, we find in the Bible this man, chapter 15, and verse 11, the Bible said a certain man had two sons. 15 and 11 of St. Luke. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country. This parable goes on. He's talking about this parable, someone gets up one day and he takes all the blessing that God has given him, all the blood that was shed when he washed your sins away, then stripes was put on his back when he healed your body. When you go back on God, when you leave God and you go out and you begin to spend your living, your money with riotous living, that's like God has blessed you. God has saved you. And then you turn around and you leave God. This young man left his father. He took all of his goods and left his father. And the Bible said, went into a far country. He knows there's no limit to where the devil won't take you. You backslide and you leave God, there's no limit to how far the devil won't take you. You'll be in church one week worshiping, praising God. You allow the devil to cheat you out of your soul. You allow the enemy to cheat you out of your salvation. Then that time next week you could be out in a hellhole drinking, smoking dope, committing adultery. The Bible said he went into a far country. Friend, there's no telling. Tonight, you've got people that was with God one day, going to church, taking their family to church. Tonight, their family's split up. Don't know where mama is. Don't know where daddy is. The children split from pillar to post, just wherever they can make it, wherever somebody will give them a piece of bread. Are you listening tonight? But it all started when they gathered up what they had and they went into a far country. I want you to know the devil ain't got no limits and the devil ain't got no mercy on you or your children. The Bible said the thief come to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I've come that you might have life, that you might have it more abundantly. Jesus loves you tonight, sinner. He loves you tonight, backslider. Come home. Come home. Come back to God. get too far and you can't come back, come back while you can. Praise God. He said in Isaiah 55, seek ye the Lord while he's near. Seek him while he's near. Call upon him. Call upon him. Seek him while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Don't wait till you get so far. Don't wait until you get so far that you lose contact. You don't feel the Spirit of God anymore. We're living in a dangerous time to play with God. People are playing with God. Jesus is coming. It's no time to get far away from God. It's time to draw nigh to God. It's time to pray and fast. It's time to get on your face. It's time to get your family and get them back in church and say, God, save my family. Save my children from drugs, from dope, from homosexuality. These demons are roving the streets and the highways. They're taking over our young people. Let me tell you, backslider, tonight, cold and indifferent preacher, you that's watering down the gospel, you that won't preach holiness no more, you sold the gospel out for money, you're an old Balaam preacher for reward and for position. You sold out the word of God. You will no longer preach it like it's written. God didn't call you if you call to do this thing like you want to do it. He called you to obey him. He called you to preach the word, to be instant in season. Paul told Timothy, said, Timothy, I'm getting ready to leave. I'm getting ready to leave. My ministry's over. I'm fixing to go. I'm going home. But he said, you preach the word. Preach the word, Timothy. Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, and exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. For the time will come that men will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust will they heap to themselves teachers having itchy ears that will turn from the truth and turn to lies. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. The word of God is the truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man shall come to the Father except by me. There's no other name under heaven. Not Buddha, not Mohammed, not Hare Krishna, not the Pope. No other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Other than the name of Jesus. For God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord to the glory of God. Friend, the devil ain't got no limit. The devil ain't got no limit how far he'll take you. You've got people, this time last year, that was preaching. But tonight, they're way out yonder. They're deep, and they're getting deeper. They're deep, the devil ain't got no limit. He'll put a hook in your jaw, and he'll pull you to your knees, and then to your waist. And then to your neck. And then he'll have you out there and he'll drown you in sin. Demons will take you over. Evil spirits will take you over. Don't ever let nobody tell you once saved, always saved. The Bible I just quoted to you, that he that endured to the end. You've got to endure. You've got to go. You can't stop. You can't turn around. You gotta go. You gotta keep moving. You gotta keep striving. Strive He said to enter in, Matthew 7, strive to enter in at the straight gate. For broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many be that go in there. Because narrow is the way, and straight is the gate that leads to life, and few there be that shall find it. It's time to wake up and stir yourself tonight. It's time to come back to the altar. It's time to come back to God. You've drifted too far out. You're in dangerous waters. The waves are high. The waters are vicious. Come back before it's too late. Turn around before it's too late. Come and repent. He's calling. He's calling. He's calling you. Come home. Come back, prodigal daughter. Come back, prodigal son. Come back, prodigal church. Go home. Come back. The Father's waiting on you. Come back while mercy. While mercy's on the altar for you. Come back while grace is waiting at the steps. Come back before it's too late. Oh, I know. You got a lot of preachers say they ain't, you can't go too far. They don't know what the Bible says. They preach it, you can't go too far. You once saved, you're just always saved. Let me tell you something, you got to endure to the end. You must endure to the end. Jesus said, he that endured to the end, the same shall be saved. It's time to wake up and don't play with your soul. Many people are playing. He said, Jesus said, the blind will lead the blind. The blind will lead. That's what's going on now. The blind is leading the blind. And he said, they'd both fall into the ditch. He said in Romans 13, wherefore, knowing the time, that it's high time to awake out of sleep. For now's your salvation nearer than when you believe. The night is far spent. And the day's at hand. Let us cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk circumspect and not as fools, but redeeming the time, for the days are evil. We are living in an evil time. Don't you let nobody fool you. We are living in the last days. We are living in the perverted, the sodomite age. We are living where men is laying with men and women is laying with women, and they're promoting transgender, cutting up little girls, making boys, trying to make boys out of them. Cutting up little boys, trying to make girls out of them. It's an abomination. I said it's an abomination. What's going on in America tonight and what the churches are allowed? It's an abomination when the preachers won't cry loud and spare not and lift their voices up like a trumpet and show their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. It's just a shame that the preachers have lost their backbone. It's a shame. And it's no time. It's no time to throw in the towel, preachers. And so, well, I might get persecuted. But we won't be the first ones. They cut Paul's head off. They crucified Peter upside down. They stoned Stephen to death. Beat James to death. Kill all them apostles. 12 apostles, but one. John, they tried to boil him in a pot of hot oil. And all the oil boiled out, and he jumped out and ran. Men paid a great price for the name of Jesus. Men paid a great price to preach this great gospel and tell the world that Jesus saves, that the blood of Jesus is still flowing tonight. The blood that saved me over 50 years ago will save you tonight. The same blood, the same stripes that healed me of cancer 25 years ago is the same stripes that will heal you tonight. That blood is still flowing from Mount Calvary. It's flowing for you, it's flowing for me. Though he was rejected, blood is still flowing from Calvary's hill. It's still real tonight. He'll still save you. No way. You know, a lot of preachers preach and tell folks, go ahead, when you get ready to come back, I'll tell them you better come now. Because when you get ready to come back, it may be too late. Bible says, appointed on the man that wants to die. And after that's a judgment. It may be judgment day for you when you decide to come back. So come now. Bible said, today's the day of salvation. Day to hear my voice. Hide not your heart, but come. Amen. 15 and 11. And he said, a certain man had two sons. And the young of him said to his father, Father, give me the portion of my goods that falleth to me. And he divided to them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey to a far country. And there wasted his substance with riotous living. How many knows when that younger son left the safety of the father's house? He didn't realize what was waiting on him out there. He didn't realize there was a devil was waiting on him out there to strip him, to bring him down. Till he didn't have no food to eat, till his clothes was raggedy. Evidently he done sold his ring. He was found in a mess. But when he left, he had money. When he left, a lot of times when people leave, they're well, they're not sick, but they get out there and don't realize that the devil's just deceiving them away from God's protection where he can get a hold of them. So not many days that younger son, the Bible said, went into a far country. He went from God. And that's what's happening tonight. People are turning, packing up, going into a far country, to a far place away from God. One time they prayed. One time they was faithful in church. God, faithful to pay the tithes and give for the gospel's sake. But tonight they're using that same money for dope and alcohol and prostitution. Oh, friend, it's time tonight to awaken. Call on the name of Jesus. Time is winding up. Come back to God. The younger man left God. Not many days after, the younger gathered all of it, went to a far country. And there he wasted. How many of you waste your life? You let the devil drag you out there. And you'll waste your life. And you'll come to yourself and realize that the devil's got you trapped. How many of those devils trapped many of them out there? They didn't make it back. One time they were in revivals under these tents and praising God and slapping their hands and going to church. But the devil took them so far out that they weren't able to get back. They died out there away from God. It's a dangerous thing. It's a dangerous thing not to fear God. Oh, it's time to wake up and come back to Jesus. He's calling tonight. Come home. Ye who are weary, come home. You don't know what to do tonight, come home. You're miserable tonight, come back home. Come back to Jesus. He suffered and died for you. He shed his blood for you. He'll wash you in his precious blood. That young man, the Bible said he wasted everything he had. And what's the next thing? The devil's got it where he wants it. See, he didn't ever see himself getting out there. All the devil will show you is good time. He won't show you when you're broke and naked and sick and dying. He won't show you in captivity out there in a jungle and the devil's got you cut off from God. He won't show you that. He'll show you all the good times you're going to have out there. The devil's deceptive, most deceptive. Amen. And he went. He began to be in want. Now he's stripped. Now the devil's got him stripped. And he's in want. He's hungry. He ain't got no shoes. Long as you got friends, money, you'll have friends. Them same friends that's supposed to be friends when you get broke, they ain't your friends no more. They don't know you. They don't know you no more. But what he was, it was the devil fooling you out there. Now he stripped you. And you're in want. There are a lot of people out there tonight in want. They've been stripped spiritually. They used to talk in tongues, have the Holy Ghost. They used to preach the gospel and cast out devils. But tonight, they've been stripped. They went away from God. They turned and thrown the towel in. They compromised. They sold out holiness and the truth. Like what Paul said, the Spirit speaketh expressly, that in the latter time some shall depart from faith, the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. From search turn away. So he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country. And he sent him to the field to feed the hogs and swine. Here he is with money in the father's house. Got up and left and went to the far country. And now he's stripped and broke and hungry. And he's asking for something to eat and he sends him to the field to feed the hogs. And I guess he intended for him to eat with the pigs. That's where the devil will take you. He'll take you from the Father's table where you're eating his flesh and drinking his blood, and he'll take you way out there to the hog pen. You're eating slop. You're eating some of the old filthy stuff that the devil has. Listen to what he said. And no man gave to him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare? I'm perished with hunger. How many of my father's hard servants. The Bible said he saw himself. It's time you see yourself tonight, backslider, under the sound of my voice. You just turned away from God. It's time you see yourself. See where the devil's took you to. He ain't took you as far. He will take you if you don't come back. Make up your mind. The Bible said he saw himself. You know what he said? I'm not going to do. You've got to make up your mind tonight. I know what I'm going to do. I'm not going to eat. He would have eaten. And he saw his son. He said, my father's servants got better to eat this than I am. I'm starving. I'm perishing with hunger. I know what I'm going to do. I'm not going to stay out here and die. I'm going home. Oh, I'm going. We're being taken over by communists and people are backsliding. We're being taken over. This country is sinking like the Titanic. You know what they said about the Titanic? Oh, the Titanic can't sink. But the Titanic went down. But God sent a piece of ice out there. Cut that old thick hull of that ship. And the Titanic went down and they didn't have enough lifeboats for all the people. You know, when you trust in man and not in God, you're going to get caught. These people said, God can't sink the Titanic. That was a foolish statement. And knows God can do anything he wants to do.